Hello, in this video I'm going to show you how I've set up my OpenIPC drone and how I wired everything together inside to hopefully give you some inspiration on how to build your OpenIPC drone. So let's get into it. So I have already shown you how I built my OpenIPC goggles. I have shown you how to flash an OpenIPC camera, but I still haven't shown you how I built my OpenIPC drone. So this is it. It's built around a slightly modified Pavo 20 frame from Beta FPV. I'll show you the modifications in a second. But the main idea is, instead of the original Pavo 20, which has a battery on the bottom, I opted for having a bigger battery on the top. I am using these 2S 930 mAh LiPos, which just slide into here. And this gives the battery a bit more protection if it's not on the bottom, and instead here I have just some foam which acts as a landing gear, which makes this drone quite robust. The main body part here was 3D printed in TPU, and you can see it didn't print very well because my TPU was wet, it absorbed some moisture, but it still works as a functional part. These protrusions here, which look like a bit like cat ears, they are not just for aesthetic, they are also to protect the camera from any sort of impacts like this. And also the fact that this is made of TPU, it also means that I can easily connect my cable. So when I need to connect it to my router to change some settings through SSH or through the configurator, I can just like unscrew this screw partially, unscrew this one fully, and I can connect the cable like so. So it's quite convenient this way. So I will now disassemble this drone to show you how it's connected on the inside. I'll need to disconnect the LED strip. And it comes off. So the main modification I made to the frame is basically to make these protrusions a bit lower. In the original frame, they are a bit higher. But to be able to mount the Wi-Fi module under the flight controller, I needed some more space. So what I did is I used a soldering iron to heat up these metal inserts to push them down. And then I sanded off the plastic that was left. So this allowed me to essentially have 1 mm. Yeah, it's around 1 mm height. Let me just check. Yeah, it's like 1.2 mm height. So just to be able to mount the Wi-Fi module under the flight controller, like so. So I am using the EU2. Wi-Fi module using a 3D printed bracket like this. You can find it in the description. Someone made a file for 3D printing this. And as you can see, I have my BEC here, so it produces 5 volts. So this drone's flight controller, the 5 volt BEC it has on the flight controller is just not powerful enough to provide enough reliable current for the Wi-Fi module and the camera. And also you can get additional noise, which would make the signal worse. So it's recommended to have an additional BEC connected from the battery terminals to the camera and the Wi-Fi module. And also I'll show you how the camera is connected. Yeah, I have this 3D printed part here for mounting the antennas. You can find all the 3D printed parts in the description. I made them available on Printables. So the 5 volt power from the BEC, it goes to the Wi-Fi module. And the ground is also connected to the Wi-Fi module. But then from there, it is also connected to the camera. So the 5 volt power comes into the camera here. I found that this is a place where you can connect power, and it's essentially soldered to one of the terminals of a diode. But be sure that you have not accidentally shorted it to some other pads, because there are some ground pads right next to it. So after you solder, you need to check continuity between these two pins. So the first one is power and the second one is ground. And if you have continuity between them, then it means you have probably made a short here. So yeah, just be careful. And yeah, the USB is connected here. You can see that the yellow wire goes into this pin of the Wi-Fi module. And the green wire is the data positive, and the yellow wire is the data negative. And also there is this other wire, which goes from the flight controller into this plug, which is the UART for the OSD. So essentially the flight controller sends data like battery voltage, flight time, all the things that you want to see on your OSD, and sends them to the camera via UART. And this piece is just a protector for the camera. I also made one like this, which I think looks nicer, but it gives the camera less protection. I made this version filled in here so that there is a smaller chance of, let's say, wet grass going in and touching the camera board. So I'll just show you what the camera looks like here. I'm using a lot of these rubber dampeners, which are used for mounting flight controllers, but I just found them very convenient for also mounting the camera. And the lens is actually a lens from a broken Runcam FAM Pro camera, which I originally bought an M12 lens, which was bigger. And I designed a protector for the bigger lens, but I realized that I can probably reuse this much smaller lens, and I made this this smaller mount, which you can also find in the description. So now it's time to assemble it again. So you might ask, is this objectively the best OpenIPC drone you can build? Well, probably not. It depends what you're looking for. I made it like this because I wanted it to be small and durable. You can bump it into rocks. You can like crash land it on concrete from like more than a meter, and it won't mind. Like when you like drop it from a higher height than usual, it has a tendency to flip like this. But it's not a big issue. It does this probably because the frame is like at the very bottom, so it wants to like tip over. Yeah, and I'll show you what the weight is. Yeah, it weighs around 142 grams. So it's on the heavier side as far as 2-inch drones are concerned. It hovers at about half throttle. So the power to weight ratio isn't great, but like for just cruising around and occasionally doing some flips, it's good enough. And in terms of just like relaxed flying, I can easily get 5 minutes of flight time on these batteries. So it works well for me. It worked well as a sort of very durable test bed. Like if you're trying to test different settings and some of them might lead you to lose video mid-flight and crash, then it's good to build something very robust and durable like this. So hopefully you found this video useful, and I'll see you in the next one.